What does Las Vegas and LA's 50-style coffee shops have in common? Many of the same architects designed both. The sign and canopy of the Sands Hotel, designed in 1952 by Wayne McAllister, is a larger version of his Bob's Big Boy, built back in Burbank in 1950. The style was popular nationwide. They nicknamed it Googie, after a coffee shop named Googie's located at the corner of Sunset and Crescent Heights. It was designed in 1949 by John Lautner.
I used to hang out at Googie's all the time in the 50s looking for James Dean, and he never shut up.
Today, many of the coffee shops built in the 50s, like Googie's, are in ruins. They are vulnerable to destruction, primarily because of their desirable locations, but they are also momentarily out of fashion. Most styles go through that limbo, though their value is sooner or later rediscovered.
Here in Downey, at one time we had an old church, an old school, which has been removed to Knox Berry Farm.
Rose Metcalf's family has lived in Downey since the turn of the century.
Now we have to go on vacation and pay to see these attractions that were once in our own neighborhood.
This McDonald's in Downey, the oldest in the nation, may suffer a similar fate. By 1968, people seemed to be getting tired of futuristic design. They were more comfortable with the past once again. The shingled mansard roofs that replaced Googie turned Main Street into a monotonous sea of oatmeal.
Not all California coffee shop architecture was great, but it still stands up even when it's been trashed. It took the mundane functional requirements of a building and turned it into architecture with a capital R.
Architect Alan Hess defends Googie's overlooked success as an architectural style in his new book, Googie, 50s Coffee Shop Architecture.
Carolina Pines Jr. at Sunset and La Brea, designed by Armay and Davis in 1955. The letters sprawl across the signboard.
Now look at the same sign today. The letters are too tasteful, too neat, too small to be effective in the jumble of the street. Something's happened between 1955 and today. Just last year, across the street, Tiny Nailers, one of the last car hop drive-ins in Los Angeles, was torn down. A city where the drive-in was an indigenous art form is just now losing the remnants of its style.
The coffee shops are rusting away like chrome spaceships on a wood grain Formica planet. Romeo's Times Square is now called Johnny's. Its walls were an abstract mural of the New York skyline. Today, it is mutated from a plastic and steel Futurama into this. James Polos, the owner of Pans in Inglewood, is bucking the tide.
We plan to remodel Pans. We were going to remodel it up to date, like a Marie Callender's. But we realized we had something good, so we want to bring it back to the 50s, the way it was.
Only a few others remain in something like original condition. Witch Stand on Slauson and Overhill, Jerry's on Vermont near 6th, Chips and Hawthorne, and just down the street, Holly's.
Big boy, should he stay or go?
His fate is in your hands.
Vote today.
Well, I think it's a gimmick to bring the big boy back into focus. You know, that it's a great idea.
The founder of Bob's Big Boy Restaurants, Bob Wyan. There really isn't any doubt about the big boy's future.
Chips Westwood wasn't so lucky.
And terrible news tonight for some people, yes.
If you're a fan of 1950s architecture in Los Angeles, well then tomorrow could be a sad day for you. It is the last day of business for what's been a landmark in Westwood, the Chips Coffee Shop on Wilshire Boulevard.
These two lamps here are about all that's left of Chips. This is a world lamp. It looks sort of like a world, kind of goofy.
Kiva Rosenfeld was a regular at Ships.
And this is the teardrop, famous teardrop lamp. Teardrop lamp.
Where else could you go when your budget was low? Ships, my friends, ships. And progress compare to one chocolate eclair.
Bernie ships, Wayne, who also gave us the song ships. There She Is, Miss America, was a regular at Ships.
They demolished Ships with no regard to any of the interior fixtures, any of the architecture. They just trashed it totally. And about a week before they were going to demolish it, I found out they were going to tear it down, so I organized this candlelight vigil where we published it in the paper, bring your own candles, bring your own toasters. They had toasters on the table, so you could have any kind of, you could have rye, wheat, whole wheat, any kind of bread, and you toast your own bread on it.
Where else were you able to make toast at your table?
It was the only place in Westwood that was open 24 hours. It was the only place that had any kind of distinctive feeling. If you could look at it, it's all one monolithic slob of concrete now. And Ships was something that was very distinctive to all of us that lived here. So we kind of miss it.
So what if they build an emporium, or a bank, or a leafy arboreum? A lost cause, let us pause in memoriam. For Ships, my friend, ships.
Never say never.
For Ships, my friend.